Hi, I'm Gabe, Director of Quizzes for Season 3 of The Mole. Thanks for watching every episode this far, and be sure to follow us on Twitter so you can tweet your live reactions every week. Also, make sure to follow us on Instagram so you can get exclusive bonus content each week we have a new episode. So you might be wondering why I'm here. The Mole actually captured me, and the only thing they give me to eat is raw eggs, and I'm pretty hungry. Come on. All right. It's a lot of yolk. All right. Oh, it sounds like the mole's coming back. We don't have much time. Make sure to subscribe to Schmear Studios on YouTube so you can watch every episode and every past episode. There you can see all the past episodes of Season 3, as well as Season 1 of The Mole, which I was a part of. They're coming! Tell my story!
Previously on The Mole.
I'm back!
13 players began a series of tasks, working together to earn money that the winner will eventually take home.
The current pot is at $65.
However, one of these players is the mole, hired by me to secretly sabotage the group's efforts so that he or she can earn money for their own pocket. It's up to the players to figure out who the mole is and track his or her every move, because at the end of each round, there is a quiz on the identity of the mole, and the player with the lowest score in this quiz is executed and must leave the game immediately.
We caught Anna talking with Craig. And we don't know what about.
That's her strategy every season, is let me be the sketchball that nobody knows enough about. She plays it so freaking well.
Would you like to come back into the game for $4 out of the group pot?
For $4 out of the group pot?
Yes, you can re-enter the game.
Hell yes.
Gary's back. Why? How did that even happen? Totally confused. I don't understand if that means Gary is the mole or if it means he's absolutely not the mole.
And I think that's BS because he was out and then took our money to come back in, which makes no sense.
I feel like I have an advantage now, knowing, well, that eliminates like one person kind of.
Four is back again. It took Gary $4 to come back into the game. And everyone's catching on that and I hate it.
It's definitely Joey. I don't care if I get kicked out next round because I'm going with my gut, it's Joey.
I'm still thinking Joey's the mole. Still probably gonna answer a few of the questions not to him, so I don't get out.
Joey, sorry. You're the mole, six victims.
I'm gonna get run, guys.
Steph! At least you're with your lover now.
Six remain, but only one will win. The one who answers the question, who is the mole?
So as you may know now, Joey's out. Joey's not the mole. And Joey was who I thought was the mole, as you know, and I put my quiz, every single question was based on Joey. So I guess Steph just had a really slower time than me, because I had like 33 seconds or whatever. So basically, I'm fucked because like when the tasks are happening, I'd only write down what Joey was doing. So I have no information on anyone. So maybe like I can get that out of Michelle, but I'm fucked right now.
Okay.
Why do you
want to
talk?
Cut the crap, Levy. Alright. Now,
what's happening?
You tell me what you talked about with Greg.
I just was excited because I thought Joey was the mole.
You're lying. Like, are you?
You know what? She's going to be watching this and apologize because I am not lying.
I thought Joey was the mole too. I put him on my quiz for every question.
For every question I put him on.
Then how is this happening?
Because I probably took a... Because she thought it was Joey too.
But if we both thought it was Joey, and she was the one
who took the slowest...
Alright, but I've been guessing Joey for the past 7 rounds.
Me too. You should see my confessionals. I'm like four. I'm like four.
I'm like, it is Joey. It is Joey. It is Joey. I'm like, I'm gonna win.
I'm like, I know. I said, I know it. I don't even care anymore. I'm like, it is him. I walked out of the last confessional. And I'm like, no, it's not this. It's Joey. I was positive it was Joey because of the four.
Alright. I don't even know what to think now. My target, Joey, is now out. The four is meant jack fucking shit. And Steph, my closest ally, is out. Like, we were working with Adam and Michelle to some degree, but now neither one will trust me.
Why did he do the fours? Is that a coincidence? Did he do that on purpose? Why would he do that? I'm done.
Me and Anna Levy are totally at back at zero. We thought that it was Joey 100%. Well, at least that's what she's telling me. And Joey's gone. All I know is that everyone wants to have sex with Joey. I don't know if Joey's the mole.
I'm just gonna try and make sure everyone thinks I'm the mole. Which I think Michelle thinks now, so that's pretty good. I'm just gonna go off of that.
And now I'm obviously represented. Let's start on maybe.
Let's just start off with
that. I'm thinking maybe Hannah. Mariah is not on my radar at all.
I'm really glad that I made it to day two. I honestly did not think that was gonna happen. I'm really confused right now because I don't even know what to think about everybody. I started off the day really suspicious about Mariah because I didn't really know anybody else. But now Mariah's not really acting that suspicious, so she's kind of off my radar.
Robert's out.
Robert's
definitely not.
Why?
Because Robert is just, like,
too new.
Too new. He's not good enough
and
to,
the fact that
to play it
saying,
off.
Exactly.
He's not,
he's good not enough deceptive enough to be able to
he's
say.
He's not, like, we're like hobbling
to
the
He's not deceptive enough to be able to say, I chose Joey and
yeah, he's
my
not,
friend.
He's too, like,
he's
real.
Too
his emotions
real,
are too
real. Although he said to me, Hannah's super suspicious, don't you think? And then when I found Dora's notebook, Steph came up to me and when we were reading it together, she goes, by the way, Robert doesn't think she's suspicious, he's just saying that to you.
Because he's trying to, I don't know what he's
doing. Yeah, but I believe that. I'm suspicious of Hannah, that's about it. Robert is out, he is not the mole. Anna Levy is not the mole. Mariah is not the mole. So I'm gonna say it's Hannah.
Mariah, I don't even know, like, she's so sketchy. Like, I can't read her at all. I need, like, some, like, therapist, some, like, mind reader right now, trying to see what's going on in her head.
Now, the problem is, they brought back Gary.
Uh-huh.
And the entire time I've been guessing Joey and Gary, up
uh-huh.
until this round.
Yeah.
So, now that they bring back Gary, can Gary be the mole? Can they eliminate the fucking mole and bring him
but
back?
But they brought him back for $4. Anyone would come back for $4.
Exactly, so that makes me think he had another motive to come back.
But then would they do that? I don't know if that's a thing.
I don't know if that's allowed. It shouldn't be allowed. I don't think it should be allowed.
I feel like because they eliminated him, it can't be Gary. They wouldn't eliminate the mole and then bring him back. I'm not sure.
So yeah, Anna's definitely the mole. In my opinion.
Why?
Because she's just been suspicious since after dinner. Well, the dog walking and then opening Pandora's box, like those two things right next to each other, that was really suspicious. And she's just very sneaky, in my opinion, so yeah.
But the fishy Gary business, said he's like more that. Than anything confused. He's like, I don't even know what the fuck I did on that quiz. He's like, so to come back, he's like,
no way. I can believe that.
Because Gary's aloof.
Yeah,
he's probably been guessing the whole game, the whole thing.
Mm-hmm. I have to try to go with Gary and be like, oh, like, we got the Notre Dame's, you got Michelle and Anna, we need to work together to try to make this. Like, I feel like I just go on my own at this point. Gary thinks it's Anna, but you got fucking executed, what does he know? Unless Gary's the mole, they executed him, knowing he's the mole, comes back and takes money out of the pot. That'd be genius. If Craig thought that would be genius. If he didn't, then he should've. But he probably did, because Craig is a mastermind at this shit.
Let's
I think Robert kind of might think it's me because
we
just
get out of here and say nothing got done between the two of us.
We just fought.
We just fought. Be really pissed off at each other. Be like, we don't know where the fuck she stands. Because I've been playing off, like I did last season, that you're the mole. Whenever anyone talks to me, I'm like, we're not really, I don't know. Like, she's not really telling me anything this round, this season.
I have to like go through my notebook so much tonight to see what everyone has done wrong. Because it's just, I'm sorry for zero right now. Like, I'm starting from round one. It's so hard.
So pretty much right now, I have no idea what I'm doing. I'm gonna fake it till I make it.
plan is to make Adam Levy look like the mole. See if that works this year. We don't know.
The money's awesome, but I would rather win mole and get nothing because I'm a winner at heart, hopefully.
Congratulations, guys. You're the final six, and you have made it to round number six. So, before we start task number 10, final task of the day, we need you guys to discuss amongst yourselves and choose one player most likely to watch you in your sleep. So go ahead and...
Joey's gone.
To be honest, I would hold myself too.
She said you're watching me today.
Well, in a very scary way.
Gary is chosen as the player most likely to watch the others in their sleep. He is brought upstairs where he is told to decide whether or not three players of his choice would choose to sleep inside or outside tonight. Then, one by one, the players are brought upstairs and asked if they would rather sleep inside or outside. For each answer that Gary correctly predicted, $5 will be added to the pot.
Alright, Michelle, I just have one question for you. Will you be sleeping outside tonight?
Is it up to me?
If you answer yes, you sleep outside. And if you answer no, you sleep inside.
So in my head, I'm like, Michelle, everyone else is going to choose outside. So just choose outside. Be the fun one.
Yes, I sleep outside tonight.
Outside you shall sleep. Thank you. Anna?
Yes?
I just have one simple question for you.
Okay.
Will you be sleeping outside tonight? If you say yes, you're sleeping outside. If you say no, you're sleeping in the basement.
No.
Sleeping inside? Okay. There will be a tent set up outside tonight.
Okay.
In the backyard, on the grass. Will you be, if you say yes, you will sleep outside, and then you're sleeping outside. If you say no, I'm sleeping inside, you'll be sleeping inside. That's up to you to decide. I can't give any more information.
No, I want to sleep inside.
You want to sleep inside?
Yes.
So you'll be sleeping inside tonight?
I want to. Am I?
If you say
Am
no,
I?
Then you sleep inside. This isn't what you want. This is what you're doing.
Okay, no.
You're sleeping inside?
Yes.
Okay.
I don't trust you.
Will you be sleeping outside tonight? If you say yes, then you will sleep outside tonight.
What
if I say no? If you say no, you'll be sleeping inside tonight.
I'll sleep outside.
Yes?
Yeah.
Okay. That's it.
Don't look at me.
No.
You're sleeping inside tonight?
Yeah.
Okay. That's it? Are you sure?
Wait, no.
It's up to you.
No.
No?
Wait, what did you... No,
think it out loud.
I can't. Okay, so I'm thinking, what if I'm the only one sleeping outside? I'm gonna get like murdered. Like I can't
in
sleep
the backyard?
Outside. Yeah, I can't sleep outside by myself. Like what?
In Long Island? You're gonna get murdered?
I can't, no. I can't
sleep. Why would you sleep outside?
Why would I sleep outside? Because what if like everybody else picked yes and then I'm like the one bitch that sleeps inside?
True.
Okay. I'm not sleeping outside.
Why?
Because I don't want to be alone. I don't want to... No, I can't.
You sure?
No.
For task 10, we asked the five people besides Gary if they would be sleeping outside or not. Of you five, two of you answered yes, you will be sleeping outside tonight.
Only two of us!
So you two will be sleeping outside.
Yes, Michelle!
God bless.
You two will be outside in our tent tonight, our luxury suite.
Hello. I'm sleeping in a fucking tent with Robert. I thought I was gonna be the fun one. I was like, oh, Michelle, it's so typical of you not to sleep in the tent. I mean, hello? I hate sleeping in uncomfortable places. I always end up sleeping upstairs on the couch every year.
I didn't mean to do that.
I thought Emma
asleep, and I miss everything, and I said everybody's gonna pick outside, Michelle. Be the fun one this season.
You get to have a slumber party with Robbie.
Go with the bitch of the season.
Nobody else cares if they're the fun one. They all chose inside like normal people, and now I have to sleep outside forever. This sucks so bad.
But now on to Gary's part of the task. So we brought him upstairs, and we told him to bet on three of you guys and what you guys would answer for if you'd be sleeping outside tonight. So first, he said that Michelle would say no. So unfortunately, no money is added there. Then he said Robert would say yes. So $5 is added for that. And then he said that Mariah would also say yes. So no money is added there. So you guys added $5 from this task.
I think Michelle and Robert did it because they thought everyone was gonna do it. But I did it specifically because I thought no one was gonna do it.
I hope you know how to build a tent.
We have to build it?
Yeah.
Oh my god. I'm just using my sleeping bag. I've never gone camping before in my life. Like, I don't do anything. I literally just sit home and watch Netflix. Like, I don't do this. Like,
So now, for the four of you guys that are sleeping inside, we're gonna offer each of you $2 now if you would like to join Robert and Michelle in the tent. So, if you would, you can raise your hand now. You have 10 seconds to think.
$2 per person?
$2 per person.
So all six.
Well, possibly. Whoever says yes. Whoever says yes, you're sleeping in the tent. But
$8.
It'd be up $2 per person. So take a second to think. The pot right now is at $70.
$70.
They had 86 people last year.
I don't understand. I'll get the $2.
Why?
It's like 100 people. I'll never be able to sleep outside.
Stephen gets like 2 out of 6 correctly.
Thank you.
Why aren't you doing it?
I think I'm going to do it.
Okay, alright, the time is up. So we're gonna start with Hannah. Are you gonna take that $2 offer? No. Hannah? No. Gary?
Nope.
Mariah?
No.
Okay, so we're not gonna add anybody.
And then I really wanted like to get $8, because to me $8 is like a lot of money out of the pot or into the pot, and so I'm like, yeah, I'll sleep outside for $8, but no one else was having it, so I'm like kind of disappointed. I'm still suspicious of Gary, and now I'm a little more suspicious of Anna because she really refused not to go outside. Hannah, I know she wouldn't go outside, so I wasn't surprised.
I'm so pissed. I really am. Like, I'm really, really mad. I should have just said no. I don't want to do it. I don't want to sleep out there. I really don't.
Yeah, I'm kind of glad I did not have to sleep outside. And no way I would do it for $2. And everyone else didn't, except for Robert, and obviously because they got chosen, but yeah, $2 is not worth it.
Anna's still very sketchy. Gary is like a little less sketchy, but he's still kind of there. Robert, I just don't feel like he could be the mole. I don't know. And Michelle, I also don't feel like she could be the mole. I don't know. I'm just very confused right now.
You special friend, you.
Sorry, we have some nice bonding, some strategizing going on, you know.
We're outside!
It's gonna be hot downstairs, we're all gonna suffer.
Hashtag the season of couples. Holy hell.
Okay, Mom.
Mom.
Robert, looks like we're sleeping outside. How do you feel about that everyone else said no?
Mariah was like, oh, I'll do it. And then she's like, no one else did it. So she's like, oh, I'm not. Hannah is giving no reason whatsoever. Gary's like, oh, I like being cold. It's frick as hell outside, so why don't you go outside? And Anna, I at least understand, like, her allergies, whatever, but... Yeah.
Allergies.
Yeah, my ass. Sorry, we'll strategize later, right?
I guess we're gonna have to.
I mean, it's gonna be good. We can build off each other. Think of this as a gift. That we can work together, us too.
You know, Robert...
Do you not trust me?
I don't.
Okay.
I don't, because I know some information about you that I...
What do you know?
Actually, I wish I didn't.
What do you know?
I do know that you told Anna Levy not to tell me about the fours.
I did.
But you told me about the fours before that anyway.
Oh, God.
So, it's like close.
Well, now the fours mean jack shit.
Yeah, you're kind of screwed. That's okay, though. You'll get by, I'm sure.
So, we're going to end the day at $70. Congratulations, guys. You survived day one.
Made to day two, so I'm super pumped. I mean... Day two, my first goal was making past first execution, then it was day two, did that, now I'm focused on winning. Six people left, four make the finale, gotta get two of them out.
I think if I have time to like sleep on it, I will dream about who is the mole. And I think, yeah, I think I'll have it tomorrow, so yeah.
Good morning, Robert. Quick, get up. Your next task starts in 10 minutes.
You're joking.
I'm serious. Let's go. Michelle's been kidnapped.
Your lover is gone.
You have 10 minutes Bailey's to be in the kitchen the before the task starts and your time starts running out. Let's go.
Guys, Michelle's been kidnapped.
Wake the fuck up.
So, if you're a player, your next task starts in 10 minutes. You'll have time to get ready after the task, but you gotta get up now.
Wait, we have to go like this?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can't even brush your nasty teeth.
No, you gotta brush your nasty teeth. Please brush your nasty teeth.
You're not a gross little
boy. You got 8 minutes now.
Get up!
To find Michelle, the players break up into two groups. One group of three at the house, and one group of two in a car. The group of three must talk to Michelle over the phone and ask her a series of yes or no questions to try to figure out where she is located. The group has a maximum of 50 questions to ask her. Meanwhile, the two players in the car must drive around and try to locate Michelle. They can communicate over phone with the players in the house. However, they cannot communicate directly with Michelle. It's up to the two players in the car to find Michelle within 30 minutes. If they can do this, $15 is added to the pot.
Do you have the country station on?
I'll turn to you.
No, I don't even hear it.
What do you want to listen
to? No, I don't listen to anything.
Are you in a supermarket?
No.
Are you in a restaurant?
No.
No.
I'm just gonna do it because we have 50 questions. Are you in jail?
No.
Hello?
Yeah. We've got so far, but it's in Plainview.
Okay, go back.
Yeah. Okay. She's inside somewhere.
Okay.
In where?
Inside somewhere.
Is there a restaurant?
It's not a restaurant. It's not a school. She's never been there before, right?
I don't know. What is can I have a map?
Plainview is just like a town. There's
No, they haven't figured it out.
It's like Bethpage, it's a town.
Okay.
I live in Plainview, but I don't drive, so I don't know where anything is.
Was fast food considered a restaurant?
That's what I would say, but
they sell food, but it's not a supermarket, but it's not a restaurant. Wait, what the hell is that? What is that name of the place that they were talking about? The gas station that you all love. That's a Bucky's, but it's not a Bucky's.
Oh, what is that called?
Do they know about Bucky's?
No.
It's a really
nice gas station.
That you guys were talking about that you're like, it's so much more than a gas station. What is that called? I don't think they're there. Can we ask
about,
executed players?
Are you talking about Wawa?
Is that it?
But we don't have that here. Oh. That's like New Jersey,
I'm
Philly.
There's so many shopping centers in Plainview that I just
don't. Have you been to the bowling alley before?
I don't think that'd be open right now.
Hey.
Hi.
Okay, so we found out also that it's a store.
Okay.
That sells food, but it's not a restaurant and it's not a supermarket. What should we ask?
Is it in like a
strip mall?
Like a shopping center, like a strip mall kind of thing?
Oh, is it in a shopping center? Yes.
Yes, okay, so it's, what are the shopping centers in Plainview? Okay. Is it in the same shopping center as
La Piazza?
La Piazza?
Okay, they're asking if it's in the same shopping center as something else. As what? La Piazza? Is that a place?
And then when we said to Hannah, we're like, asking if it's in the La Piazza parking lot, she's like, La Fiasco? Like, she kept on mixing it up, so that was really suspicious.
La what? Here, let me tell you.
Yeah.
Wait, say that again?
We out.
La Piazza.
Oh my god, it's Jeff.
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 We see Jeff. Jeff. We see Jeff.
Did we win?
Where's Jeff going? To get bagels. Oh, for bagels.
Is it a convenience store?
No.
Alright, straight or right? Straight or right?
I don't know. Right?
Okay, we don't need a hop. We're in a challenge right now.
Alright, are you guys thinking of
anything? Hello, don't you people want to find me?
I don't know where what the fuck Plainview is.
Michelle, we're lost. I think you're gone. Call your mom.
Call
your mom.
Oh, it could be like a bagel store. It could be like... Oh, wow, we thought about that
weird. How can I be more specific?
Do they sell bagels?
Huh?
Do they sell bagels?
Yeah.
They sell bagels.
Oh, is it where your dad gets the bagels?
They sell bagels? Maybe where Jeff was.
They sell bagels.
Are these chains national?
Yeah.
Oh.
National chain.
So it's like a big chain place that sells food.
Einstein's bagel. Where's that? Do they sell donuts?
She said yes.
Dunkin' Donuts. Okay.
Dunkin' Donuts.
Probably, right?
Yeah.
Oh.
It is Dunkin' Donuts. Did she say yes?
Yeah.
It's Dunkin' Donuts. It's Dunkin' Donuts. Wait, which one though?
How many Dunkin' Donuts?
Oh crap, we gotta find which Dunkin' Donuts.
Is it the one by Panera?
Is it near Panera? Fuck! Where the fuck is it?
No, we just don't have that a lot here. And it's like...
You're wasting time!
Closest Christmas.
No, we don't need your sass.
The closest one is in Penn Station. No, there's one.
You guys don't know any other Dunkin' Donuts?
Can we Google it?
No? Oh my god, this sucks.
Are you sure it's in Plainview?
Yeah, it is. We have 5 minutes? Drive, Robert.
Okay, you just told me to slow down.
Break all the rules.
Alright, honestly, I'm lost. I really don't know.
Is it in Plainview that's closest to Bethpage? Is that a real question? Yeah.
Are you deep in Plainview?
No.
No. Are you guys by Monty's?
Yes.
Go to Monty's now.
You're near Monty's? Isn't that an old Bethpage? Fuck. That's not legal. That's not legal.
No, we're
no.
trying to win.
No, Robert's driving is not legal.
No. Go to Monty's.
Are you fucking kidding me? You said that you wanted to go to Monty's.
But you guys are really far from
Monty's. Yeah, because that's in Old
Bethpage. Hello.
You guys have 2 minutes to get to
Monty's. Go,
Get, there's a Dunkin' Donuts by Monty's, I think. Get there.
Go. Robert, let me get out.
Sorry,
go.
Oh, kick it out.
We did it.
Is it on time?
Yeah, it's 9:05. We came in at 9:05.
Oh.
And then it's 9:06 right now, but we were here at 9:05.
Yes.
Something was a little fishy.
About them?
About them.
Who?
Yeah, we were told Plainview.
Questions asking?
Yeah, this is Plainview.
This is Plainview.
Oh, this is
dumb bees. They were dumb bees.
Who?
People asking questions. They didn't ask very good questions.
We need to ask all the questions for us.
So Gary really should have been the one asking the bigger questions, and he wasn't.
Yeah, she was a bitch, though, because she said Plainview, not Old Beth Page.
Yeah, you know the page, right?
Monty's is not Old Beth Page.
Wait, where's Monty's?
Monty's is old.
Yeah, that's what I said. That's why I said not to go.
They had pretty much 30 seconds when they found me. I said it was in Plainview, not Old Beth Page. I didn't mean to sound kind of shifty, but everyone kind of thinks I did, and that was wrong, but I didn't mean it.
We're calling you on it right now.
What?
That's Old Beth Page over there.
That was technically
Listen to me, I've never been there before. I'm not on Plainview.
You're passed by a sign that says, welcome to Old Beth Page.
I hope.
Well, Michelle said it was in Plainview, and last time I checked, that don't give me Monty's in the Old Beth Page, because it is. Like, I don't blame her, really. I think that was an honest mistake. The tent was horrible. Actually, no, it wasn't too bad.
I honestly didn't think that challenge would go well. Like, obviously, Hannah and I had no idea what we were doing, and it seemed like Anna wasn't really sure what town was, but she said she didn't know Beth Page. Maybe she knew Old Beth Page, apparently. Because we were told it was in Plainview. Apparently it was Old Beth Page, with like New York cities blend together. I don't know, it's confusing.
Mariah legit sits there and does nothing. Like, oh my god. She said like 5 words all game. She has not done anything.
The Notre Dame people on my side of the task were, you know, they did fine, but they don't live here, so they didn't know a lot. But right now, I'm definitely suspecting Michelle and a little bit of Anna.
They were getting really stuck on the fact that I said it wasn't a restaurant, because Dunkin' Donuts isn't a restaurant.
So it was me and Anna. I didn't want to be with Anna because I don't suspect her at all. I wanted to be with either Mariah or Hannah. And when I said, I think a non-Beth Page person should come in the car, they were silent. Because, like, Anna would know which questions to ask. We had to tell him what to ask in order to figure out it was Duncan. So, that's why I don't think it's Anna. She was able to figure out it was Duncan.
That challenge was interesting because we were all really tired. I know some of us just weren't like really feeling it at that point. But I thought it went pretty well. Everybody like participated pretty good.
We made it, but it was tiring and I'm tired and I just want to go to bed.
Alright, well first off, I'm on day 2. I'm pretty freaking happy. Final 6.
Okay, so I was sleeping in the tent, was not that bad.
Yeah, woke up seeing Michelle's kidnapped, but we were able to strategize last night, which was pretty good, bounce off ideas from one another.
Me and Robert both have jet lags, so we're both up talking, so that was okay. Went to bed at like 2:40, which kind of sucks, but like we weren't going to be able to sleep any earlier than that, so, then this morning I was kidnapped.
Alright, this is a Pandora's box round, so I'm gonna put it over here and anyone can open it while breakfast is still going on.
Oh no, I don't know what touches it.
I'll open it.
Craig, we're wearing matching shorts.
Okay. Alright.
If you do it, then you take away money from the group. How do you feel?
I'm prepared. I'm prepared because we're in this stage of the game. I feel like this is an advantage.
No. You think so?
Yeah.
All right.
What is it?
No!
No.
At 30 seconds to your quiz time.
We all knew it was bad, Gary.
Could have been good.
Wow.
I should have given it to
you. I don't feel bad. 30 seconds to your quiz time? You better take 0 time on your quiz.
I know.
Unless you just take it. So quick. Well, I mean, if you get questions
than the lowest person that ever got it.
It's now time for the 6th execution quiz, 10 questions about the mole's identity. The player that scores the lowest on this quiz will be the mole's 8th victim. Question 1. Is the mole male or female?
I'm suspecting Michelle a lot because she told us the Dunkin' Donuts was in Plainview, and it wasn't really in Plainview, it was in Old Bethpage. So that's a really big, you know, red flag.
2. Was the mole chosen as the most likely to watch you in your sleep?
I hope people think I'm the mole. At this point, it's good to be shifty in the game because if you can make yourself look like the mole, it's just one less person you have to worry about.
3. Did Gary bet that the mole would sleep outside?
So at this point, Joey's gone. Everybody's freaking out. Robert doesn't know what he's going to do. He's like, I'm going to lose the game now. Because Robert pretty much was banking on the fact that it was Joey, but he was doing his quizzes really, really fast. So now that he has no idea, I think he's probably going to get out soon.
4. Did the mole sleep outside?
The one like big controversy was that Michelle said that the Dunkin' that she was in was in Plainview when it was really in Old Bethpage. And so, I mean, that really didn't mean anything to me because I don't know where any of this stuff is, but that could be like a big, I don't even know what I'm trying to say, but like, that's not good that she did that because that really threw off the people that like actually knew where they were going. So that makes me suspicious of Michelle.
5. Was the mole kidnapped?
I don't know who's the mole. I don't know. I don't have any suspects. Maybe Hannah? I don't know. I don't know. I'm tired. I'm done. I'm not done. I want to win. But I have this quiz is going to be a shit show because I'm just going to guess because I have no idea. Whew. Mole. 2K15.
6. Was the mole ever in a car during the task kidnapped?
I'm actually surprised that we did the challenge and like the 30 seconds slip. It's kind of suspicious that they said that it was 15 minutes away, but then they were there like in a minute or so. But my suspicion is still on Gary. I still think he's the mole, so that's what I'm gonna roll with for this quiz coming up.
7. How many players were in the mole's group in the task kidnapped?
So right now, Gary and Anna suspect one another. So hopefully one of them leaves so I can cross out the other.
8. Who sat to the mole's right during breakfast?
And I'm really down to Notre Dame. As much as I hate to say it, I think it's one of them, and I'm leaning towards Hannah. Like, even with the egg and sleeping outside, she gave no reason as to why she didn't want to do them. And then Mariah just is so quiet. I told her early in the game, I told her people suspect you're the mole because you're not writing a lot. She began writing a lot more. So I don't know if that was her trying to be like, oh look, I actually am not the mole. Because that's what I wanted to observe, so.
9. What did the mole put on their bagel during breakfast?
No one really suspects Notre Dame. Like, people suspect Michelle now. I hope people suspect me. Because I was just driving around in circles, honestly. And I knew that. So hopefully they suspect me. I'll try and make it more obvious that they put me on a quiz. I hope I make it to Final Four. I mean, that's my next goal. I gotta make it past this execution. It should be fun, I don't know. Hopefully. Sorry, this wasn't as interesting. I'm pretty tired. Don't sleep too well on the grass. Or for 5 hours. Thank you. Good night.
In question 10, who is the mole?
Sixth execution ceremony, and one of you is about to be the mole's 8th victim. Let's begin. Anna. Anna, you're safe. Mariah. Safe. Anna. Hannah, you're safe. Gary. Gary, you're safe. We're between Robert and Michelle. Which one of you would like your name to be called?
Omar.
Michelle? Michelle. Michelle, you're safe. Robert.
I don't know what that means.
Robert, I'm sorry, you're the most eighth victim. Please come with me. Robert, what's your reaction to being the most eighth victim?
I mean, I knew it was gonna happen. Like, all my intuitions were just out of the door. I had to start from round one last night. So, I don't know, I was expecting it. It's been fun. It's been a good experience.
I'm here to win. I don't care if I leave with nothing. I want to win.
I just swallowed that. So, can we do like roleplay?
Yeah, you don't. You don't
Ding dong, the witch is dead. How do you guys feel?
The season is finally out.
So we are like, are we all fair players?
Yeah.
Or is someone gonna turn? Who's
gonna turn? Are you unsure now about yourselves?
Nah.
How do you
honestly,
feel?
Honestly, he wasn't a helpful execution because I'm pretty sure we all knew it wasn't Robert.
Yeah.
So him leaving just pretty much.
How do you know it wasn't Robert?
It was not Robert.
Yeah. Intuition.
There's no way it was Robert, so
that didn't help at all.
It was
there's
yeah.
only one guy
there you
didn't
go.
Help at all. He did risk us like $24.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, then he got out.
You owe us $24.
Yeah. He doesn't care.
But we enjoyed having you here, and we'll see you later today when we figure out who the mole is and who the winner is.
Tempting, but I'm empty. Will you only say? You know lyrics, Robert. But you see the tempting, will it make you feel like cheating? I'm like, oh, not really, cause oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader.
She's always right there when I need her. Oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader. She is always right there when I need her. She grants my wishes like a genie in a bottle. Yeah, yeah, 'cause I'm a